Hello everybody, I am Baljit Dhaka from Pinnacle Coaching Center, and today we are going to discuss paper code 722. This is part 3 presentation, and in this we will discuss question from 52 to 75. Question number 52 is ABCD is a trapezium in which AB is parallel to DC, like this. AB, C and D, this is parallel to. Now AB is 8 cm, BC is 10 cm, DC is 12 cm, AD is 16 cm. Then what is the value of AC square? What is the value of AC square and BD square? Means the diagonal. Now this is a property, and this is very important property. You must remember this, memorize this. AC square, that is BD square. AC square, that is BD square, would be equal to AD square plus BC square plus 2AB and CD. 2AB and CD. Now this you have to remember, this is important property. If you want to understand this property, you can take example of, let's say, trapezium as a square, and in that you can multiply like this. This is, let's say, this is 2 centimeter 2 centimeter 2 centimeter 2 centimeter, 2 root square plus 2 root square, because diagonal of a square is 2 root 2. Root 2, A is here 2, so then it would become 2 root 2. And then AD square. AD square in this case would be equal to 2 into 2, that is 4. BC square, BC square also, this is B, this is C, A and D, would be 4. And then 2AB, that is 2AB, 2 here, and CD, 2 here. That is here would be equal to 16, and this is also 16. This is also 16. So it confirms that this is a property. This is a correct property. We have taken to understand in a faster way, I can say faster way, I have taken this as equal to trapezium. Now put here value, and that is equal to AC square, BD square would be equal to AD square. AD we have 8 into 8 power 2 plus BC square. BC we have 10 power 2 plus 2 into AB, that is 8, and CD, that is 12. That should be equal to 64 plus 100 and plus 192. That is equal to 16 square, you can say 256. BC square is equal to 10, that is 100. 2AB, 2 into A into AB and CD, CD is 12, 192. Total would be equal to 548. Answer should be D. Next question, question number 53. Two poles of equal height are standing opposite to each other. Equal height, standing to opposite each other on either side of a road which is 100 meter wide. 100 meter wide, and this is H and this is H. From a point between them on the road, angle of elevation of the top are 30. Let's say this is 30 and this is 60. Height of the each side of the pole would be, well, we have to find the value of H. Now this is X, then this would be 100 minus X. So H by 100 minus X is equal to tangent 30, that is 1 by root 3. So H is equal to, here you will find 100 minus X is 100 minus X or you can say this is equal to root 3h. Root 3h is equal to 100 minus x. And in the second case, this h by x is equal to tangent 60, that is root 3. And here h is equal to, or you can say x is equal to h by root 3. H by root 3. Now put here h by root 3. Or root 3 h is equal to 100 minus h by root 3. That would be equal to root 3 h and plus h by root 3, which is equal to 100. You can take common h, then we will have root 3 plus 1 by root 3 and into 100. That is equal to 3 plus 1, 4. Which is equal to 100. In other words, you can say value of h would be equal to 25 root 3. Answer is A. Next question, question number 54. A barrel contains a mixture of wine and water in the ratio 3:1. How much fraction of the mixture must be drawn off and substituted by water so that the ratio of wine and water in the resultant mixture in the barrel become 1:1? 1:1. This is 3:1. You can say 3 is a wine and 1 is a water. And we have to make it 1:1. In other words, if let's say this is a 9 and 3. This is 3:1. So total is 12. So it will become 6:6. You can also put an other value. You can also take like 12 and 4, 18 and 6. This will be, but here you will have to find that it should be equal 6 and 6, and that should not come in fraction. Now, how much fraction of the mixture must be drawn off and substituted by water? So 9 plus 3, 12 is the total mixture. And from this we have to reduce. So how will it become 6? Then when we will reduce is 3, and when we will reduce add here 3, then it will become 6:6. So this 3 is, if I divide it 12 into 3:1 ratio, that is 9 and 1. So out of 9, this is 1 by 3. If we, or out of 14, 1 by 3 of 14 would be equal to 4. So 3 is this and 1 is this. So this is in fact equal to like this. 9 minus 3 plus minus 1 and plus 4, plus here. Plus 4, because total is a subtracted 4 liter mixture. Out of 9 plus 3, 12. 4 liter mixture is subtracted, and out of 4, 3 is wine and 1 is water, and total added is now 4 liter water. So it will become 6:6. This is equal to, question is how much fraction of the mixture, that is 4 out of 12. You can say 1 by 3 has been subtracted to make it 1:1. Answer is B. Next question, question number 55. Total cost price of 15 article is same as the selling price of 10 article. Profit percentage would be how much? In such kind of question, what you have to do is that take difference, and difference divided by selling quantity into 100. That would be the profit or loss percentage. Cost price of a 15 article is same as selling price of 10 article. Obviously this is profit, and profit is 5 rupees on selling 10. On 100 it should be equal to 50% profit. Answer is C. Next question, question number 56. Respective ratio between present age of Manoj and Vasim is 3:11. Vasim is 12 years younger than Rehana. Rehana age after 7 years will be 85. What is the present age of Manoj's father, who is 25 years older than Manoj? So this is a complicated question. However, when you solve according to the statement, then it will find easy. Rehana age after 7 year will be 85. Now current age of Rehana, current age is 85 minus 7, that is 78. Current age. Wasim is 12 years younger than Rehana. So Wasim would be 78 minus 10, that minus 12. 66 years is the age of Wasim. Respective ratio between present age of Manoj and Wasim is 3:11. 3:11. Manoj and Wasim. So Manoj is 66. Wasim is 66. Manoj would be 18. Because value of x is 11x and 3x. Value of x is here 6. 66 by 11, that is 6. So 18 is the age of Manoj. Question is, what is the present age of Manoj's father? Manoj's father, who is 25 years older than Manoj. So 18 is the age of Manoj. 25 plus we will have 43 is the age of Manoj's father. Answer is A. Question number 57. A sum of money is divided among W, X, Y, and Z in the ratio 3, 7, 9. You can say W, X, Y, and Z. 3, 7, 9, and 13. If the share of W and Y together is rupees 1172, then what is the difference between amount of X and Z? If W and Y, if the sum is 12, then difference of X and Z would be equal to 6. If this is 12, then difference is 6. If this is 1172, then it will be equal to half. So half of this would be equal to 5586. Answer would be C. Next question, question number 58. Length of the largest possible road that can be placed in a cubical room is 35√3. Surface area of the longest, largest possible sphere that fit within the cubical room is. Surface area of the largest possible sphere. This is in fact cube and surface area. This is largest sphere. And largest sphere here, this radius would be equal to half of the side, and from this we can find the value of side. The longest, largest possible road, that is, this is in fact diagonal. So diagonal of root 3a, diagonal is equal to d, which is root 3a. A is side here, so root 3a is equal to 35√3. A is equal to 35. This total is 35. You can say diameter is 35. Diagonal is 35. R value would be equal to 35 by 2 of a sphere. Surface area of the sphere would be equal to, surface area is 4 pi by 22 by 7 and R square. 35 by 2 into 35 by 2. 110 into 35. 3850 would be the surface area of the largest possible sphere. Answer is B. Question number 59. A certain distance is covered by a vehicle at a certain speed. If half of this distance is covered by another vehicle in double the time, the ratio of the speed of two vehicles would be A and B, two vehicles. If this is one, then half of this distance, certain distance covered by vehicle. If half of this distance is covered by another vehicle in double the time, distance is half and time is double. It means this speed would be 4 times less. If the speed of A is 4, then speed of B would be 1. Ratio of the speed of two vehicles, that is 4:1. Answer is D. Question number 60. ये फिर एल एम एन पी ए पैरेललोग्राम, दिस इज पैरेललोग्राम एल एम एन एन पी एन आर बी परपेंडिकुलर टू एल पी, परपेंडिकुलर टू एल एंड पी. लेट्स टेक एल पी दिस साइड, इट विल बी इजी, इट विल बी इजी टू कैलकुलेट देन. दिस इज परपेंडिकुलर पैरेललोग्राम एल एम एल एल एम एन एंड पी एन आर बी परपेंडिकुलर टू एल पी, दिस एल पी एंड एन आर इज परपेंडिकुलर टू दिस. इफ एरिया ऑफ द पैरेललोग्राम इज सिक्स टाइम्स द एरिया ऑफ आर एन पी, आर एन एंड पी, दिस इज आर एन पी एरिया एंड पैरेललोग्राम एरिया इज सिक्स टाइम, दिस एरिया दिस पोर्शन इंटायर इज सिक्स टाइम्स द एरिया ऑफ आर एन पी. आर पी इज सिक्स सेंटीमीटर, आर पी दिस इज सिक्स सेंटीमीटर. वॉट इज द एल आर वैल्यू ऑफ एल आर, एल आर वैल्यू वी हैव टू फाइंड. नाउ द एरिया ऑफ दिस इज वन बाई टू बेस दैट इज सिक्स एंड हाइट, दिस इज हाइट एंड एरिया ऑफ पैरेललोग्राम वुड बी, एरिया ऑफ पैरेललोग्राम वुड बी इक्वल टू base into height and here base is 6 plus this you can take value of r base into height h and this is 6 time of this, so multiplied by 6 you can write here, that should be equal to 3 plus 36, sorry this would be equal to 3h, 18h would be equal to 18h. This side is equal to 6 plus 6h and plus xh. So 18 minus 6, that is 12. 12h is equal to xh. Value of x is 12. Answer is B. LR is B, 12. Question number 61. If tangent x plus y is equal to root 3, cot x minus y is equal to root 3, then the what are the smallest possible value of x and y respectively? Now very easy question. Value of tangent 60 is in fact root 3 and cot 30 is root 3. So when will it become 60? When we'll have 45 plus 15 and here 45 minus 15. Then it would be 30, which is cot 30 is equal to root this, root 3. What are the smallest positive value of x and y respectively? So x is equal to 45 and y would be 15. 45, 15, answer is C. Next question, question number 62. A, B and C start a small business. A contributes 1 by 5 of the total capital invested in the business. 1 by 5 you can write here. Out of 500 he is investing 100 rupees. B contribute as much as A and C together. A and C together. Let's say this is 100 rupees. Out of 500 I am taking total investment 500 rupees. And A is investing 100 rupees. This is 1 by 5 of the total capital. B contributes as much as A and C together. A and C together. So let's say if it is 200, then it should be equal to 300. But if it is 150, then it should be equal to 250. So 250 plus 150, that is 400 and this is 500. So 250, 150 and 100, in this way they are contributing. Total profit at the end of the year was 5200. What was the C profit? C profit would be 150 out of 500. If it is total 5200, then it should be equal to 1560. Answer is D. Next question, question number 63. Here you will find 1 plus sine x plus sine square x plus sine square x. You can say sine x is adding every time. In fact, this is geometrical progression, GP question, and this is given is sum in geometrical progression is given by a 1 by r. This is the formula of sum of geometrical expression in this series, and this is in fact a value of a sum that is equal to a, that is first, and this is the ratio, this is ratio in fact. The difference here will have sine theta, sine l, sine x every time, this is the ratio in fact. So a divided by 1 by r is equal to this, you can say a here is equal to 1 minus value of r is adding every time, so we are taking r which is common. So sine x, and that is equal to 4 plus 2 root 3. We have to find the value of x in this question. 1 minus sine alpha is equal to 1 by 4 minus plus 2 root 3. Or you can write to this, you can rationalize it. You can rationalize it. Then we will have 4 minus 2 root 3. And here we'll have 4 divided by 4. This is equal to this. Now see, 4 minus, you can write this expression in this format also. 4 divided by 4, that is 1, minus 2 divided by 4, that is 1 by 2, root 3 by 2. So this expression is equal to this. 1 minus sine theta, sine s, this is sine x is equal to root 3 by 2. Sine x is root 3 by 2, and root 3 by 2 is equal to 60. So sine value of x is would be equal to 60 degree. Answer is C. Here this you have to remember. Question number 64. Mr. X, a businessman, had income in the year 1995 such that he earned a profit of 20% on his investment in the business. In the year 96, his investment was less by rupees 5000, but still had the same income plus income is equal to investment plus profit as that of a, that in 1995. Thus the percentage profit earned in 1996 increased 6%. What was his investment in 1995? Now here you can write, let's say businessman income is X in starting, and profit earned is 20% on his investment. Profit is now 0.2X, you can write. This is investment, profit and income is equal to 1.2X in 1996. His investment was less by rupees 5000. So instead of X, investment is now X minus 5000. 5000 less. But still had the same income. Income is same, 1.2X. As that in 1995. Thus the percentage profit earned in 1995 increased 6%. Earlier it was 20%. Now it is 26%. That is 1.26, you can multiply it by 1.26, which is equal to 1.2x. In other words, 1.2x, this is 26% now. 126 by 100, you can say x, this is equal to minus 1.2x is equal to 1.26 into 5000. This is equal to 0.06x, and 1.26, you can write 126 by 100 into 5000. Here you can also write in place of decimal 100, you can cancel to this, this is equal to 21. Value of x is equal to 21 into 5000, that is 105000. Answer is C. So what we have done, x plus 0.2x, that is investment profit, total income. Income in the same second year is same, and investment is 5000 less. Profit is 126 by 100, so which is we have made it equivalent. Next question, question number 65. If cos alpha cos beta is equal to m, cos alpha cos sin beta is equal to n, then find the value of this expression would be equal to what? You can put value in this expression. Let's say alpha is equal to 60 degree, beta is equal to 30 degree, then we will have cos 30, cos 60, cos it will be equal to, cos 60 would be equal to 1/2, and cos beta, that is closer to root 3 by 2. So this should be equal to 1/√3. You can say m. Now here cos alpha, which is equal to 60 degree, means 1/2 divided by sine beta, this is sine, and sine beta, that is 30, is equal to 1/2, that is equal to, you can say 1, n here is equal to 1, m is equal to √1/√3, m square here would be equal to 1/3 plus n square, that is 1. That is 1, so it should be equal to 3, 1 plus 3, 4/3. 4/3 cos square beta, beta we have taken 30, that is √3/2. √3/2 into √3/2. Here you can write 1. So now see from the option which is representing 1. This is not representing, this is not representing 1, this is representing 1. N square, that is 1. If n is 1, then we will have 1 total. Here 1, if n is 1, 1 into 1, we will have minus 1, but this is satisfying condition A. Answer would be A. Next question, question number 66. The perimeter of two squares are 24 centimeter and 32 centimeter. Perimeter of two square are 24, this is 24 and 32. So side would be equal to 6 and side would be equal to 8. Perimeter of a third square equal in area to the sum of the area of the these square. So area would be equal to 6 into 6, that is 36, 8 into 8, that is 64. So total area would be equal to 100. Side would be equal to then 10, because 10 into 10, 100. Now question is, perimeter would be equal to this. So perimeter would be equal to 40. Answer is B. Question number 67. In this question it is given, this is 7, total is 14, total would be equal to, we have to use here pi r square theta by 360 minus pi r square theta by 360. Here you can take pi r square pi and theta by 360, that is 30 by 360, pi by 12, this is pi by 12, you can say 22 by 7 into 12. This is, you can take common, and r square minus r square, r square would be 20, total would be 7 plus 14, 21. So 21 square minus r square, that is 7, 7 square, 22 by, here you will have 84 into 21, a square minus b square, a plus b and a minus b. So 21 plus 7, that is 28. A plus B, and A minus B would be equal to 14. That should be equal to 308 divided by 3. 30 divided by 3 would be equal to 102.667. Answer is A. Next question, question number 68. If 2A plus B divided by A plus 4B is equal to 3, then find the value of A plus B, A plus 2B. You can cross multiply this. We will have 2A plus B and 3A plus 12B. So minus A is equal to 11B. This will go this side and this will go this side. Minus A is equal to 11B. Here you can write 11B plus B and 11B plus 2B. This is minus A is equal to 11B, or you can say A is equal to minus 11B. Here you can write minus A, this is minus 11B, and this is then minus 11B and plus B. So minus 10B divided by minus 9B. 10 by 9 should be the answer. Answer is C. Question number 69. A rectangular paper 11 cm by 8 cm can be exactly wrapped to cover the curved surface of a cylinder of 8 cm. Volume of the cylinder would be how much? Now, this is cylinder, and in fact 2 pi r is equal to 11 here, because this is the length, this is the length, and this is 8 cm. This is 2 11. So 2 into 22 by 7 into r is equal to 11. In other words, you can say r is equal to 4 by 7 by 4. Volume of the cylinder would be pi r square s, that is 22 by 7, r square 7 by 4 into 7 by 4, and h is equal to 8. Then it should be equal to 77. 77 centimeter cube would be the answer. Answer is B. Next question. 70. A train 800 meter long is running at the speed of 78 km per hour. If it crosses a tunnel in 1 minute, then the length of the tunnel would be how much? So 800 plus x, this is the length of the tunnel, and the speed of the train is 78 km per hour. You can say 78 into 5 by 18, which is equal to 1 minute, that is 60 seconds. So 800 plus x is equal to 60 into 78 into 5 by 18. That is 1300. 800 plus x is equal to 1300. Value of x would be equal to 500. Answer is B, length of the tunnel. Next question, question number 71. Area of a right angle triangle. Area of a right angle triangle is A. If its one of the perpendicular side is B, then length of altitude, this is altitude, from right vertex to hypotenuse would be how much? Now here in this question you can say that this is a triangle, right angle triangle, and area is A. So, and if it's one of the perpendicular side is B, this is B, then length of altitude from right to vertex to hypotenuse would be how much? What is question? The length of the altitude is this, from the vertex, from the right angle vertex to the hypotenuse, would be equal to this. You can take it x, and here the area is equal to A. Total area is A. We have to find the value of this x. You know, 1 by 2 base, take it A, 1 by 2 base, that is A into B, is equal to a, is equal to a, and which is equal to 1 by 2. This is this you can also find value of a would be equal to, value of a would be equal to 2a by b. You write here 2a by b, 2a by b. Why we are writing this? Because we have to find in this term, in this term. So here you can write 1 by 2. This is value base, that is 2a by b, 2a by b into b, which is equal to 1 by 2 base into height or perpendicular, which is equal to this hypotenuse and height. So 1 by 2 hypotenuse would be equal to then b square plus 4a square, 4a square divided by b square and root of this, or root of this, and into x, into x. So right here b square plus 4a square divided by b square. If you open bracket, then we will have, you can cancel to this b, b 2 2, and this is equal to a. So x is here 1 by 2, this is base and this is height, altitude you can say. Value of altitude would be equal to then 2a, and this is equal to, in fact this will go to this side 2a, and into this entire would be equal to, you will write here b square and then b4 plus 4a square, b4 plus a square. So if you go to, you open this root, then we will have b here and divided by 4a square plus b4, and root of this would be equal to x, 2ab, 4a square and b square. This would be the answer. Answer is a, because this is matching to this answer. Next question, question number 72. Work done by a woman in 8 hours is equal to the work done by a man in 6 hours and a boy in 12 hours. Now you can say the work done by a woman in 8 hours is equal to the work done by a man in 6 hours and a boy in 12 hours. Man, woman and child. 8 hours, let's say total work you can take, for example 24. In 1 hour A is doing 3 unit, woman is doing 3 unit, man will do 24, that is 4 unit, and child will do 2 unit. If the work is same in all the cases, their efficiency would be 4:3:2. Now see, if working 6 hours, now this question you can start from here. Man work is in 1 hour 4 unit, woman will do 3 unit, and child will do 2 unit. This is their working efficiency. If working 6 hours per day, 9 men, 6 hours per day, that is in 1 hour they are doing 24 unit, 9 men into 9 and 6 days into 6, this is actually the total work, this is actually the total work. Then in how many days the 12 men, 12 women and 12 boys together finish the work, working 8 hours a day. This is the work, and this should be equal to 12 men. 12 men, that is 48. You can write it in 1 hour. In 1 hour, efficiency of this team would be equal to total. In 1 hour, efficiency of this team is equal to 12 into 4, that is 48. 12 into 3, that is 36. 12 into 12. And 12 into 2, that is 24. This is equal to 40 plus 108. So their total efficiency in 1 hour would be equal to 108. So you can write here 108 into 8 hours per day and number of days. This expression is equal to this. Now you can write here value of x would be equal to, this is number of days, 3 by 2, this team will take 3 by 2, that is d would be the answer to complete the work. Question number 73. A bicycle market at rupees 2000 is sold. This is MRP. 2000 is sold with two successive discount of 20% and 10%. 20,000 into 20%, that is 80 by 100 into 90 by 100. That should be equal to 1440. An additional discount of 5% is offered for cash payment. 5% discount, you can see here. 72 rupees discount is again offered here. That is equal to, now selling price of the bicycle at cash payment would be equal to this. You could have done also here 95 by 100. You could have done also here 95 by 100, and now this would be equal to 1368 should be the answer. Answer is A. Next question, question number 74. Here you can follow 50%, that is in compound interest, you see P and 1 plus 50 by 100. That should be equal to 3 by 2. So P into 3 by 2. Earlier it was P. P 1 you can write here into 3 by 2, that is in 5 years. So this is in 5 years. But if the term is 10 here, that is 2 times. So this is 5 years, then it should be equal to 2 times here, then you will have this. This should be equal to, because amount is same in all cases, P1 into 3 by 2, and this would be equal to then 3, because this is 15 year, which is equal to, this is P2 here, and this is P3, 3 by 2 and power 3, power 4, because this is for 20 years. Now see, and let's see, this is equal to K. We can consider this is equal to K. Then P1 would be equal to K into 2 by 3. And P2 would be equal to then K 2 by 3. And P3 would be equal to K 2 by 3 and power 4. So this is the ratio of P1, P2 and P3, that is K. You can cancel K in all cases, then we will have 2 by 3 power 2 ratio 2 by 3 power 3 and ratio 2 by 3 power 4. This is the, in fact, ultimately the ratio of XYZ, you can say. Now 4 by 9, this is 4 by 9, which is equal to, which is ratio 8 by 27, and this is 16 by 81. So that should be equal to 81, take LCM, then we will have 36, 24 and 16. 36, 24, 16, it will be go by 4, then we will have 9, 6 and 4. 964, answer should be C. C would be the answer. Answer is, next question, question number 75. Three vessels contain equal mixture of milk and water in the ratio 6:1, 5:2 and 3:1 respectively. If all the solution are mixed together, ratio of milk to water in the final mixture will be how much? So 6 out of 7, 5 out of 7, 3 out of 4, this is milk, and 1 out of 7, 2 out of 7, and 1 out of 4, this is water. So total milk would be equal to, let's say LCM is 24, LCM 28, then we will have 24, 20 and 21, that is equal to 65 by 28, and here you will have 4, 8 and this is 7, 21 by 28. So in 28, if you see this is 28, this divided by this, milk divided by water, 65 ratio 28 and 21 by 28, you can cancel to this, 65 ratio 21, this is in fact 19, not 21, 8 plus 4 12 plus 7 19. So 65 and 19 is the ratio. Answer is D. So in this way, we in this presentation we have covered question from 51 to 75. Thank you very much for watching this presentation. All the best.